right, I told you it was going to be quick. Let's jump straight into game three. We're headed to Zelnaga Caverns up here in the top right. We're going to have Complexity's RSVP as the red Protoss. Down here in the bottom left, from its Gosu, it's going to be DDE as the blue Terran. And, you know, Zelnaga Caverns, I think if there's any map, you spoke about how RSVP, you've heard rumors that he's kind of a cheesy player. If there's right. one map where he could do something cheesy, I would expect it to be on a smaller map like this, not on a map like we just saw where he went DTs.
Yeah, you know, I grinded through a couple replays just to get familiar with the style before we started this cast. He played a very nice game on here where he four-gated, Terran had bunkered up, and he didn't attack, he just expanded behind the four-gate and had some very nice force fields as Terran tried to move down with his three-rack. So I'd like to see him play that sort of style. The one thing that he's going to benefit from here is that DDE has shown that he's done that gasless fast expansion time and time again, and yeah. I would not expect to see him do any sort of risky play like that here. So if I'm RSVP, yeah, I'm going to risk it. I'm going to four-gate, and if it doesn't work, then I'll play defensively, but at least I can put a lot of pressure on a fast expansion.
Yeah, I mean, if you fast expand on this, let's just take a look at the natural, as pretty much everyone always does when casting this game. You have a wide open area all the way around it, so just really susceptible to any attacks. There's the gas going down right away from DDE, so it's looking like somewhat of a normal build here.
And surprisingly, RSVP has gone for a 14 gateway, so a very economic build here. I want to see how quickly he takes his gas. So he's going 14-15 and chronoing the Nexus yet again to get the maximum amount of probes out. He's already up to 16 probes, going to be at 17 supply coming very soon. So this is a very economic build, and when you're labeled as a cheesy player, that's not something you would expect to see.
Yeah, definitely. So Rax is going to finish. And it's really going to come down to how DDE opens up. I kind of feel like at this stage in the game, Terran really makes the pace of the game. And then later on, as we kind of approach the mid game, it's going to be Protoss that really changes that and what tech path they go. So we have the Cybernetics Core going down. Nothing building from that gateway just yet. Hasn't added on that second gas either. In the meantime, looks like DDE will be walling off, probably to get either a bunker or another depot to wall off here in the center. There is the tech lab going down. We might see some early aggression if he starts making marauders and gets slow.
Yeah, RSVP looking very standard here. He's on one gateway with the cybernetic score up. He's only got one assimilator, so we'll have to keep an eye on what he's up to. He's making a zealot, so he wants to chase away this SCV. Both players haven't really shown their hand here. Okay, now DDE has shown his hand, yeah. Getting concussive shells. So he's going to be doing that two marauder, one marine push, and this will drive back the Protoss, create space and allow him to get a fast expansion up. He should probably bring one or two SCVs with this rush, but it's not intended to kill him, just make space and expand.
Yeah, I mean, this build has been around pretty much since the beta, I want to say. Trying to think back who started this, and Kathan Luck actually comes to mind, if you can remember that name, Chill.
Yeah, I remember him.
Yeah, he was actually one of the players that played a lot of the MLG Showcase series back in beta. So, a Zealot moving forward, and oh no, that...
What?
That's kind of random and not good. I mean, losing the initial Zealot is not good whatsoever. You need that extra unit. There are two Stalkers out, but two Stalkers kind of get destroyed as Marauders chow down on them with the slow and also just with the extra additional damage to armored units.
Yeah, RSVP is looking a little shaken after that. If you look, he's got two gateways coming, but one is significantly behind the other one. So it's not like he timed out this build to be a three gate, and that was his strategy. After losing that Zealot, he put the second one down. So a little bit strange here. He's proxying now a Twilight Council.
Uh-oh.
So three gate blink, possibly, or he's just going to go back to default DTs.
Yeah, this is going to be pretty hard for him to hold. He's going to need to pull probes. One of the, one of the Stalkers goes down. If he can get a lot of damage out on some of these other two Marauders with that Stalker, he's going to look in pretty good shape. Two more Zealots popping out. This is going to come down to how well DDE can control.
Yeah, and with Warp Gate about to finish, I think he'll be fine. He's going to lose that Stalker yet again, but it's not like he's going to die to it. Two Zealots out now, and Warp Gate is finishing. Zealots going for those Marauders. Let's see Dark Shrine on the way. So going DTs yet again, living up to his reputation.
Well, It might have been Artosis, but I mean, if you try once with DTs, try again because they might actually work. But
why not?
Marauders are taken out. And the big thing here is detection. We have a second orbital. 4 DDE has not started any engineering bays, though, so we're going to be watching his energy count on these two orbitals. Dark Shrine is about halfway. This is looking pretty similar, actually, to last game out of RSVP.
Yeah, playing a little bit behind as Nexus is behind DDE's expansion, but I like the way he's played this better. He's not going to die in the next 2 minutes, or at least I don't think he's going to. He's going to get up the Dark Shrine while not losing his natural, which is a nicer way to do it. He's already suffered a little bit of damage, and he's behind if you kind of line the builds up economically comparing them to each other. But, you know, DTs can do magic, so don't count them out yet.
They can. Here is the pylon that will be warping in those DTs, and it's in a very scouted spot, so DDE might see that. He does have 2 bunkers going up. Now let's take a look. Orbital Command here, about to approach 50 energy. Keep our eye on that. Looks like it was used in the main. Oh, and he does mule.
No.
And 2 DTs.
Just as the DTs run in.
RSVP kind of catching a break here.
Oh, wow. DDE, I bet you wish your macro was bad, so you didn't drop those mules.
Yeah.
Looking at the main, 32. Yeah. 3 DTs, no scans for a couple more seconds, no eBay. This may be game ending.
Yeah, it really could. I mean, he's going to be able to take out a lot of SCVs as this one's already chipping away. This one's working on the bunkers at the front. Ghosts are out, but the build time of Ghost is pretty long. He's not actually building anything. Engineering Bay is at halfway. And, you know, I don't really agree with taking out a supply depot for RSVP. He did take out these 2 bunkers. I mean, I guess the supply depot kind of works because you can supply cap your opponent, but go for those SCVs, man. Or go for the army.
I think he was trying to keep those DTs separated, but he actually put them 1 scan link away from each other, which was just a bit of a mistake. So the idea was there. He's got enough for a scan from his natural. Gonna use that in the main. So now he's stabilized. He's got the missile turret up, but whoa!
GG. DDE taking a page out of Idra's book. Well, that would actually just not be GGing, but he left kind of early in that game. I mean, he's up 2-0 in this, or 2-1 now in the series. So, you know, maybe it's just like, let's just take the loss and get on to the next game.
Well, you know, I didn't realize until I brought up the income tab, but he only had 13 SCVs to 45 probes. So
That's true.
I guess he knew it's an almost impossibly long road to come back from that.
Yeah, it looks like he lost, 18 SCVs. So, yeah, DDE definitely bowed out, probably at the right time. Our next map, it's going to be MLG Shattered Temple. So, guys, quick commercial break. We'll get on to game 4. Can RSVP take it into game 5 and actually come back and win this thing? We're going to find out in just a couple of seconds. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back.